Morning, it's a cold grey March morning here on Merseyside, on Merseyrail, where everything is very yellow. The benches are yellow, the help points and the footbridge and the signage is yellow, so it seems more appropriate than ever that today's guest, you know who's coming, it's Northern correspondent Carl!
In yellow coat.
In yellow! It's the Merseyrail coat.
Last seen at Warrington West, if you remember rightly.
Yeah. Okay, I should spray the word 777 on that.
You've got plenty of room
like
on the back.
Like a big seven,
to do that,
because
yeah.
Today, join with the hands, we're doing the class 777.
Yes, these new Stadler-built trains are now in service on the Merseyrail network, replacing the 45-year-old Class 507 and 508 trains. The new 777s started on the 23rd of January 2023 on the Kirkby branch. Other branches will get the trains at a later date, as we'll find out later in the video.
Star Trek.
Beam me up, Merseyrail.
Absolutely. Safe to say that far better than the old ones. We have light.
Oh, don't criticise the seats, Carl.
Let's just say you might end up with a numb bum.
But the point is, you're not on these trains for 4 hours.
I suppose
you're not on them for 10, 15, 20.
Hunts Cross to Southport, though, you might be on it for a while.
Would you get a train all the way from Southport to Hunts Cross? I don't know.
Let us know in the comments.
Okay. But we need a review from you about all the things that are new in Space Age.
Yep.
Maybe we'll just go with the Star Trek theme. Carl, what have you spotted? What have you spotted?
This.
What's
look
this?
At that. This is green light around the door. Oh, and look, turns red when it's closing. So if you can't hear the signal, you've got a visual confirmation as well.
What have we got up here?
We have a live map. So instead of like the old ones that used to get stickered on the things, that sometimes if there's a new station, obviously they're immediately out of date. But with this, it's live, gives you arrival times, changing points. So another thing, if you do that...
What was that? Magic?
Yeah, so you've got the plate here.
Yeah.
If you just tap that while it's closing,
yeah,
it opens the doors again. So if you're a bit slower in a wheelchair, then you won't get trapped by the doors.
But this is for the level boarding.
Yeah.
I'll do a cutter where we all know that one of the...
Do that again.
Yeah.
There you go, do that.
Thank you. One of the greatest things about the new trains is the level boarding.
Yeah.
On the old trains, not
There's
so much.
Quite a gap, wasn't there, on the old one?
Okay, I like that. Do it again.
That's good.
Thanks.
That's how it works.
It's a little bit like the new DLR train. Walk through, grab poles. Bike rack being used like that. This bit here, Carl. But don't put your bag here. No, my friend, because these... Yeah, you put your pram or buggy here. Nice, right?
Very.
You didn't realise that, did you?
No.
Flip up seats. Come on, mate. Wow. Okay. And because of that, the plug sockets are here. They've moved them. Where in other places, they're normally down here, but they've had to move them to here for the flip up seats, because obviously you can't have the plugs where you have the flippy up. You ready to go back to Liverpool Central?
Yeah, let's go.
We're just going to ride it all day, aren't we?
Yeah.
By the way, you said you were low on phone data?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Yeah, I've got you 7 gigs.
Oh, you're a good one.
Right, cheers, mate.
So, thank you.
In the interests of passenger safety...
What's that? You've spotted something that they've stolen?
Yes, from Manchester Metrolink.
What?
Now, it's one of the best hacks on Manchester Metrolink going, is that before you get to your stop, you can actually call the door.
And you can do the same here.
And look at this. This is what Metrolink doesn't have, is your way is lit. Look at that. How good is that? Manchester Metrolink, are you watching? Lights around the door.
This is a difference between old and new, between the 507s and 508s. The 507s and 508s, of course, used to have door buttons, and they're now covered up.
Yeah.
And for many years, you had to manually press the button.
Yeah.
But then it changed. Nathan, do you know when did the doors change to be automatically open? As long as you've known it?
As long as I've known it, yeah.
But on the current old units, the doors automatically open and close.
Yeah, there's a metal plate
over here. Here they don't. Mm. So you do have to press the button, and that has caught some people out, hasn't it? Because they just expect the doors to open.
You stand there and wait.
Myself has to shove down the platform.
But the trick is, you can press the button in advance.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you're from Manchester, you know what to do. Press the button before you get to the station.
Morning.
Exactly.
You filming me? Oh, you cheeky. Oh, by the way, happy birthday.
Now, ironically, we timed this wrong. We've come on the week before. It's a 15-minute service on the Kirkby branch, on all Merseyrail branches. There's only one unit in operation at the moment, but next week they're going to run 777s on all the trains on the Kirkby branch. Then they're going to run on the Ormskirk branch. And then after that, I'm not sure when it's coming. Ted, the lights do keep coming on and off. Nathan, why is that? So I need to know when the trains are going to, like, the Wirral lines. Fortunately, there's a man at Liverpool Central waiting for us right now that has all the answers. So David's turned up, he's hiding in there, but we'll interview him on the train.
Mm-hmm.
Is it the next train in? It'll be the next train in. Back in July 2021, when I made that Trains Coming Soon video, the lovely David Powell, good morning, was in that video answering some questions, and you're here again.
Ta-da!
Not by coincidence. We asked you to be here.
We did sort of arrange it, yeah.
Your programme director... Oh, the lights. Programme director, Merseytravel.
That's right, yeah.
And you helped design these trains?
Certainly did.
But the
oversaw the design process, yeah.
But the graphics on the boards said, yeah, you know, your train's designed by you. So you did get a lot of public... You did have a lot of public consultation.
That was the most important part of it, was getting the public input. So we worked with a panel of 40 regular Merseyrail passengers, tested all sorts of features, and I think we got a much better train as a consequence of taking their feedback on board.
Other questions I have. Now, the old 507s and 508s are 3 car long.
They are.
Sometimes they double up to be 6 car.
They do.
These new ones are 4 car long.
Yes.
Now, are you telling me that you know, you've gone from a 6 down to a 4? Because surely you can't double a 4 to an 8, or can you?
Well, yes, yes, okay. We can. Yes, okay. They're very much designed.
But so, the platforms aren't long enough.
They are. Or they will be. So we're still doing that work. So we don't need to run them as 8 cars yet, but we'll just finish off. We're halfway through the programme of extending platforms and moving some of the signals. We just had a line closure down at Liverpool Central, where we were closed for 3 days. That was us doing work underground to enable us to turn the 8-car trains in the underground head shunt. So there's a lot of work going on to make sure we can run 8-car units on our busier routes.
Because how many units are there in total? 54?
There will be 53 of the new trains.
And some will be doubled and some will still be...
Some will run as doubles and some will run as... Yes, fours and eights.
Why do the lights keep coming on and off?
Because they are saving energy.
Okay.
They're detecting the ambient light outside.
Okay, I like that.
It's an energy-saving thing.
Energy-saving measures. Yeah. All right, okay. Headbolt Lane.
Yes.
Now, I've seen a poster that confidently says Spring 2023. Really?
Have you ever seen a confident poster? No, I'm joking.
Headbolt Lane is happening.
We've got a very, very big construction team working up there at the moment, working really hard with Network Rail. We've got the first battery-powered train in the country doing its tests as we speak.
What number is that? 777, what number?
140.
140, thank you.
So it's been in Germany for a couple of months. It's over here now doing its tests, all going well. I've got another 3 coming. They'll be with us by the end of March.
So how many out of the fleet of 53 will be battery-powered?
Seven.
Seven, okay.
Seven. And our plan is to get Headbolt Lane open later on this year.
Okay.
Spring, let's see whether it's spring.
Okay, but hopefully this year.
Oh, definitely.
Okay.
Yes.
You've got me thinking now, could maybe really, if that's successful,
yep,
will people then go, hang on a second?
Yes, I already have.
Ellesmere Port,
yes,
let's run them to Helsby on battery.
Well,
is that a thing?
Yes.
Go on, tell us, what can you tell us?
I'd go a bit further.
Go on.
If I was going to go to Helsby, I'd go to Runcorn East, and you would start looking and thinking, could we get ourselves to Warrington?
All on battery?
Yes.
What's the range of a battery 777?
Well, that's what we've been testing over in Germany for the last few months.
Wow.
How far can these things realistically go? We can we can put a lot of miles into these things. They've got 6 tons of batteries on board.
Gosh.
And the performance has exceeded our expectations so far. So routes like the one I've just described to you, that's a possibility.
Okay.
On Monday morning, I'll be going through with our team, looking at what we think the right order to look at the extensions of the network. So we are intending to expand the network.
Talking of the network, where are we? Where we started this morning at Rice Lane.
I think we're Rice Lane.
Last question. It's obviously it's running on the Kirkby branch at the moment.
Yes.
Ironically, we've come in the week before you go all the trains on the Kirkby branch. I know you're a bit cagey on dates, but like we hear almost Kirk are getting them next. Could you expand on that as to what? Like when are the Wirral getting them? When are Southport getting them? What can you tell us?
Okay, so Ormskirk are going next.
But you don't know when.
I know exactly when.
Do you want to tell YouTube?
Yes, as soon as we can get enough drivers trained up. It's when Merseyrail and their colleagues, when we can get enough through the driving school.
Okay.
We'll also be introducing them in phases to get them out there as quickly as we possibly can. Okay. A few months ahead, Ormskirk will move to being 777s,
and then
we're going to move across and start working on the Wirral.
And then Southport will get them last?
Typically, yes.
This year or next year?
Southport might be into next year.
Okay, all right. Okay, that's it.
Great stuff.
Was that all right?
Brilliant.
Not too tricky?
No.
I'm loving it.
Did I answer confidently?
Carl complained about the seats. I think this is fine. I blame Carl.
He's
the last time I'm having it as a cameraman.
He's got a skinny bum.
Thanks, David.
Cheers, Jeff.
Yeah, mate, got your cake.
Got me a cake?
Yeah.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
I'll put that there.
7! 7! 7!
Wouldn't be a Jeff video without me lying on the floor, right? Does this look ridiculous? Or I'm demonstrating how there's space to put your legs, to put your bags.
You fit with room underneath the seat, so it's fine.
Because there's nowhere to put your bags above. Could you pass me my bag, Carl? Thanks very much. Carl, if there's no luggage rack, then what's this? There's half a luggage rack on one side. So it's not here, and it's not over there, but there is this one here. So we're coming into Rice Lane.
I'm
going to say Kirkby. We'll finish at Rice Lane. We start at Rice Lane. This is it. It's not the last time you'll ever be on the 777. But how was your date card?
Yellow.
There we go. Right. We started at Rice Lane, so we're finishing at Rice Lane.
We're
bookending Rice Lane.
See you later.
See you later, mate. You know you said yellow now, don't you?
Yeah.
You know what you've done, don't you?
I've gone to ruin the end.
I drew a line for you and everything you do. And the 777s, they're all yellow. Oh no. That's it. Thanks very much.
Pleasure.
It was indeed all yellow.
It was.
Thanks, Merseyrail. Thanks to David.
Yes, yes.
Ask people to subscribe to my channel.
Subscribe to his channel.
And all that. Love Carl. Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Always, mate.
Bye.
Pleasure.
Love your coat. That's it. See you again on the next video. Bye.
See ya.
Bye.